share with you three ways to be more resilient and stronger throughout the night. Let's start in the morning. How do you wake up in the morning? Put your hand up if you sleep within 10 feet of your cell phone. Look around the room. Put up your hand if one of the last things you do before you go to sleep at night is to check your cell phone. If you drank a bottle of wine before bed every night, woke up and drank a bottle of wine in the morning and slept with your bottle of wine. You're a freaking alcoholic, man. You're a phone-aholic. You are addicted to your cell phone. We are all addicted to our cell phone. It is not good for us. It is an addiction. It is skyrocketing. The research I just mentioned, San Diego University, he boils the entire white paper down to one phrase. The reason this is happening. Anxiety raises Skype has covered 30%. The reason is due to the descendants of the smartphone. Smartphones have three problems. They all start with the letter P. The first one is productivity. Are you kidding me? McKinsey says we now spend 31% of our day bookmarking, prioritizing, and switching between tasks. We're not actually doing anything. We're just deciding what to do. Have you ever pulled up the Netflix screen and you're like, hey, before your partner comes in, you're like, I'll put down a movie, and then half an hour later, you're just like, well, I don't know, you're still checking Rotten Tomatoes, and then trailers on YouTube. You're like, you don't actually do anything, you're just deciding what to do. The second problem with cell phones also start with the letter P. It is physical. When you look at a bright screen within an hour of bedtime, according to new research from Australia, the melatonin production in your brain goes down. The sleep hormone. When you don't produce that, you don't sleep deeply. So the next morning when you wake up, you are even lower resilience. And guess what you do in your low resilience state? See what Trump tweeted. There's like you just instinctively do it. It's like you're not ready to go yet. Never mind the fact that we're giving ourselves hunchbacks and the fact that when I went to my physiotherapist last week to complain about my texting thumb, she said to me, all we do is thumbs now. We used to do arms and legs. Do you remember kids in casts? You'd sign their cast because they broke your arm and leg. You don't break your arm and leg when you're playing Fortnite only. Number three also starts with the letter P, and this is the biggest one of all. There is a psychological problem with cell phones. You are comparing your director's cut life with all the good, the bad, the ugly, all the great things in it, and all the bad things in it with everybody else's greatest hits. Okay? I don't care where you're going for dinner after this. I guarantee you somebody's at a lobster buffet in the Maldives right now. And when you look at Instagram after your awesome meal, you're going to be like, well, my meal sucked. This looks way better. You can't win anything. Someone has more followers, has more friends, and certainly sold more books than all of us guys together. All of us can compare ourselves endlessly to people better than us at all times. Those are the three P's of growth: productive, physical, psychological. What's the solution? Plug your charger in the basement, please. And begin your day with a 2-minute morning practice that is chapter 6 from this book. I love the sound of everyone grabbing a pen. When you wake up in the morning, grab a pen. Grab a cue card or a journal or a blank piece of paper and write down three things for me. Number one, I will let go of. Number two,